بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. أدي ابن حاتيم hear the Prophet peace be upon him saying, save yourself from the hellfire even by giving half a dead fruit in charity. Assalamu alaikum everyone. My name is Dr. Marina Akhtar, PGR Community Medicine. Today, my topic of presentation is family planning, its definition and types, and failure rate calculations. I am presenting this topic under the kind supervision of Professor Dr. Saira Afzal. Learning outlines. Introduction of family planning, different methods of contraception, failure rate calculations, healthy timing and spacing of the pregnancies, HTSP, evaluation of the contraceptive methods, recent advances, and then MCQs. Learning outcomes. At the end of this presentation, the participants would be able to describe family planning, different methods of contraception, their usage, advantages, disadvantages, and their failure rate. Family planning term represents family planning to regulate the number and the spacing of children in a family through the practice of contraception or other methods of birth control. Family planning, WHO defines family planning as a way of thinking and living that is adopted voluntarily upon the basis of knowledge, attitude, responsible decision by the individuals and the couples in order to promote the health and the welfare of the family group and thus contribute effectively to the social development of a community. CPR, couple protection rate. Couple protection rate is an indicator of the prevalence of contraceptive practice in a community. It refers to the percentage of eligible couples effectively protected against childbirth by one or other approved methods of the family planning. That may be sterilization, IUD, condom, or oral pills. Family Planning 2020, FP 2020, is an outcome of the 2012 London Summit on Family Planning, where more than 20 governments made commitments to address the policy, financing, delivery, and socio-culture barrier to women accessing contraceptive information, services, and supplies. Donors pledged an additional $2.6 billion in funding. 2020 focuses on enhancement of the family planning delivery services through the political commitment and accountability, universal access to family planning services, supplies and information, develop and adapt new contraceptive methods, congenial atmosphere for family planning commodities. Situation of the family planning in Pakistan. Low utilization of family planning services. There is current CPR. Is 35%, where the target is 50% by 2025. MCPR represent contraceptive prevalence rate in by modern methods. All women is 17.7. Unmet needs in married women is 27.1, and demand satisfied married woman is 50, and TFR, total fertility rate per woman is 3.3, where the target is 2.8 by 2025. Growth rate is 2.4%, where target is 1.5 by 2025. Family planning counseling. There are two main approaches for family planning counseling. One is called GATHER approach. GATHER, where G represents the greed in culturally acceptable way, A represent ask about the client and her RH reproductive health needs and tell the client about family planning methods and reproductive health services. Help the H represent help the client choose a methods or service. E explain how to use the methods. R return visits. Schedule on appointment for routine follow-up, what to do in case of side effects or any concerns. Second approach is SAHAR approach. A client-centered approach, two-way negotiation between provider and the client developed and tested by the Population Council in Pakistan, where S represents the salutation, ट्रीट द क्लाइंट विद डिग्निटी, ए रिप्रेजेंट असेस द क्लाइंट्स रिप्रोडक्टिव हेल्थ नीड्स, एच रिप्रेजेंट हेल्प निगोटिएट अ सोल्यूशन टू द क्लाइंट्स रिप्रोडक्टिव हेल्थ नीड्स, आर रिप्रेजेंट द रीअश्योर द क्लाइंट. वट इज कॉन्ट्रसेप्शन? कॉन्ट्रसेप्शन इज मीन्स अगेंस्ट कंसेप्शन. द प्रिवेंटिव मैथड टू हेल्प वुमेन अवॉइड टू अवॉइड अनवॉन्टेड प्रेगनेंसीज आर कॉल्ड कॉन्ट्रासेप्टिव मैथड्स. दिस शोइंग डिफरेंट कॉन्ट्रासेप्टिव मैथड वी विल एक्सप्लेन लेटर. नीड फॉर कॉन्ट्रासेप्शन टू अवॉइड अनवॉन्टेड प्रेगनेंसीज, टू रेगुलेट द टाइमिंग ऑफ प्रेगनेंसी, टू रेगुलेट द इंटरवल बिटवीन द प्रेगनेंसी. Methods of contraception. There are two main methods of contraception: temporary methods or permanent methods. Temporary methods used to postpone pregnancy or space birth, where the permanent methods aim to purposefully and permanently destroy the reproductive capacity of an individual. Temporary methods includes barrier methods, natural contraception, oral contraceptive injections, implants, devices. That includes intrauterine contraceptive devices, and in permanent method in female tubectomy and in male vasectomy. Temporary methods. First one is natural method that includes LAM. LAM represent lactation amenorrhea. LAM technique, an ideal pattern is feeding on demand. That is whenever the baby wants to be fed. At least 10 to 12 times in 24 or in first few weeks after childbirth, thereafter 8 to 10 times in 24 or including at least once at night in the 15 months, and daytime feeding should be no more than 4 hours apart and nighttime feeding no more than 6 hours apart. Some babies may not want to breastfeed 8 to 10 times per day. They want to sleep through the night. These babies may need gentle encouragement to breastfeed more often. LAM lactation amenorrhea failure rate. LAM is effective for first 6 months to start and other family planning method. When menstruation returns or the baby is 6 months or the woman stops fully or nearly fully breastfeeding or the woman no longer wants to rely on LAM, there is high failure rate. And the second natural method is FAM, fertility awareness method. Practice withdrawal method or the abstinence during the fertile period. This is calendar-based method, STM, calendar rhythm method, symptoms-based method, ovulation method or cervical mucus or two-day method, BBT method, symptothermal method, multiple indicator method, cervical mucus observation. These all includes in FAM, fertility awareness methods. Failure rate is high failure rate. Also, user may forget the days or have irregulars. And the other temporary method is barrier method. There are two types of barrier method, physical barrier method and chemical barrier method. Physical barrier method includes male condoms, female condoms, diaphragms or cervical cap. And the chemical barrier method includes foam, jellies, creams and sponges. Chemical barrier methods are spermicides. Chemical-based formulation that destroys sperm cells membrane that reduce sperm motility or ability to reach the cervix. These include foams, foaming tablets, suppositories, vaginal films, creams, or gels. And the failure rate in physical methods, more chances of inadequate use, poor compliance, but these are protective against sexually transmitted infections. And the chemical methods, there's high failure rate. Hormonal methods. Types include combined oral contraceptive pills, COCs, combined dermal patch, vaginal ring, progestin-only pills are also called mini pills or morning after pills, progestin-only implants, progestin-only depot injection, progestin-only intrauterine devices. And this is the route of administration. Oral pills, almost 100% effective and protective against breast फाइब्रोसाइट डिजीज, फाइब्रो एडिनोमा, ओवेरियन सीस्ट, आयरन डेफिशिएंसी अनीमिया, पेल्विक इन्फ्लेमेटरी डिजीज, एक्टोपिक प्रेगनेंसी, ओवेरियन कार्सिनोमा। DIANA-35 इज यूज्ड फॉर डिसफंक्शनल यूट्राइन ब्लीडिंग, PCOS एंड एंडोमेट्रियोसिस। अनलाइक अदर OCPs, इन DIANA-35 आफ्टर 21 डेज वी डोंट गिव प्लेसिबो बट कॉन्टिन्यू सेम ड्रग टू अवॉइड विद्रॉल ब्लीड। इट प्रोड्यूस प्रेगनेंसी लाइक ए मेनोरिया विच इज गुड फॉर एंडोमेट्रियोसिस ट्रीटमेंट। साइड इफेक्ट ऑफ ओरल पिल्स आर रिस्क ऑफ हाइपरटेंशन, डिरेंज लिपिड, सीवियर चूज, MI, स्ट्रोक, सर्वाइकल कार्सिनोमा, लीवर डिसफंक्शन, डिक्रीज लैक्टेशन, ब्रेस्ट टेंडरनेस, वेट गेन, हेड एक, मिग्रेन एंड स्पॉटिंग। POPS मिनी पिल्स, द प्रोजेस्टेरोन ओनली पिल्स नेवर गेन वाइड स्प्रेड यूज बिकॉज ऑफ द पुअर साइकिल कंट्रोल एंड इंक्रीज प्रेगनेंसी रेट। मेल पिल्स, ग्लॉसिपोल कुड बी टॉक्सिक। द नेक्स्ट इज इंट्रा यूट्राइन डिवाइस। थ्री जनरेशन ऑफ इंट्रा यूट्राइन डिवाइस, फर्स्ट इंक्लूड्स इनर्ट और नॉन मेडिकेटेड डिवाइसेस, फॉर एग्जाम्पल लिपीज लूप। सेकेंड जनरेशन इंक्लूड मेटालिक IUCDs, कॉपर टी, नोवा टी, मल्टी लोड डिवाइसेस। थर्ड जनरेशन इंक्लूड हार्मोनल IUCDs, प्रोजेस्टासर्ट एंड मेरिना। एंड द फेलियर रेट और साइड इफेक्ट्स, फर्स्ट जनरेशन IUCDs, साइड इफेक्ट्स ऑफ ऑल IUCDs इंक्लूड पेन, हैवी मेंस्ट्रुएशन, पेल्विक इन्फ्लेमेटरी डिजीज, एक्टोपिक प्रेगनेंसी, अनेमिया ड्यू टू हैवी ब्लीडिंग इन लॉन्ग टर्म एंड एक्सपल्जन एंड परफोरेशन। सेकेंड जनरेशन IUCDs साइड इफेक्ट्स आर लेस ऑफ दीज साइड इफेक्ट्स। कॉपर टी 380A इज इफेक्टिव फॉर 12 ईयर्स, नॉट यूज इफ सेक्सुअली ट्रांसमिटेड इन्फेक्शन और PID एंड लार्ज फेब्राइड्स। एंड थर्ड जनरेशन IUCDs लीज साइड इफेक्ट्स विद मेरीना। मेरीना इज इफेक्टिव फॉर 7 ईयर। मेरीना आल्सो यूज फॉर एंड्रोमेट्रियोसिस ट्रीटमेंट बिकॉज इट हैज प्रोजेस्टेरोन। इट प्रोड्यूस प्रेगनेंसी लाइक ए मेनोरिया इन 6 to 12 months, विच इज गुड फॉर एंड्रोमेट्रियोसिस ट्रीटमेंट। इट इज कॉन्ट्रा इंडिकेटेड इन ब्रेस्ट पर्सन। द थेरेप्यूटिकल इफेक्टिवनेस ऑफ IUD लेस देन दैट ऑफ द ओरल एंड इंजेक्टेबल हार्मोनल कॉन्ट्रासेप्टिव, बट सिंस IUDs हैव longer continuation rate than the hormonal pill or injection, the overall effectiveness of IUDs and oral contraceptive are about the same. The other method is permanent method, which is 99% effective. In male, it is male sterilization, vasectomy, permanent contraception to block or cut the vas deferens tube that carry sperm from the testicles, keep sperm out of the ejaculated semen, greater than 99% effective after 3 months semen evaluation, do not affect male sexual performance, and voluntarily and informed choices essential. Female sterilization includes tubal ligation, permanent contraception to block or cut the fallopian tubes, eggs are blocked from meeting sperm, greater than 99% effective, and informed choices essential. Then an ideal contraceptive, it should be cheap, safe, effective, available, one time method, acceptable and reversible method. And comparing typical effectiveness of the contraceptive methods, less effective more than 13 pregnancy per 100 women in 1 year, and more effective less than 1 pregnancy per 100 women in WHO medical eligibility criteria, MEC. WHO medical eligibility criteria, MEC, a classification system, is used for assessing the suitability of different contraceptive according to the condition of the client, medical and non-medical. It classifies into 4 categories for initiation and continuation of contraceptive. Degree 1, use method in any circumstances, then yes, use the method. And 2, category method, then with limited clinical judgment. is use of the method not usually recommended unless it's more appropriate are not available or not accepted. No, do not use method. Fourth category is method not to be. The usual choice of the method barrier choice, if not, then polyamorous women wanting short-term contraception give OCPs after ruling out the contraindication. If she wants long-term contraception with return to fertility afterward, then use NORPLANTS. Young women with complaint of dysfunctional uterine bleeding, ovarian cysts, give combined oral contraceptive pills for additional therapeutic benefits of COCs. History of, if there is history of ectopic pregnancy, PID, endometriosis, fibroid, not large, or dysfunctional uterine bleeding, and menorrhagia, use the Mirena. For postpartum women, IUCDs, DEMPA implants, and POPS safe in the breastfeeding mother, avoid combined oral contraceptive pills for first 6 months. Older women with CVS and neoplasia risk factors, IUCD is good to use. Emergency contraception, two methods, oral emergency contraceptive pills or copper IUCD. Healthy timing and spacing of the pregnancy, HTSP. You said recommend that women practice healthy timing and spacing of the pregnancy. That means that after a live birth, women and the couple should wait at least 24 months before trying to become pregnant again. After a miscarriage or abortion, women and couple should wait at least 6 months before trying to become pregnant again. And third is adolescent should delay pregnancy until at least 18 years of the age. And four is women and men should use a family planning method of their choice to delay and space their pregnancy. Benefits of HTSP for women are reduced risk of pregnancy related complications that are high blood pressure, blocked or prolonged labor, anemia, death. Give mother 2 years to fully prepare for her next pregnancy, keep girls in school, and improve their opportunities. The benefit of HTSP for children are reduced risk of preterm birth, small for gestation age, low birth weight, stunning death, and opportunity to breastfeed for a full 2 years as recommended by WHO and UNICEF. Now, there is the evaluation of contraceptive methods. The formula is Pearl Index. Failure per 100 women years of exposure. Pearl Index equals total accidental pregnancy multiplied 1200 divided by total months of exposure of that contraceptive. Life tab, and the second method is for the evaluation of contraceptive method, life table analysis. Failure rate for each month of the use, then the cumulative rate is found out. These are two methods. Measure the effectiveness or failure rate of the contraceptive methods. Here, this table is showing the percentage of women experience the unintended pregnancy during the first year of typical use and the first year of perfect use of contraception, and the percentage continuing use at the end of the first year in USA. This table is showing the contraceptive methods. If we are using no method and the failure is 85%, typical use, perfect use is 85%. And then if they are using spermicide, 29% for typical use and 18% for perfect use. And at the end of the year, 42%. These values are in the during first year of the use. This is at the end of the year or after completion of the year. And the by withdrawal effect, 7% and perfect 4%, and at the end of the year is 3% fertility awareness. That is typical use 25%, and After 1 year, it is 51%. Standard days method, it is 5% for perfect day method, 4% after perfect use, and ovulation method, 3%. Percent in typical use and 20% use in nulliparous moment, 16% in typical use. Diaphragm 16% in typical use and 6% in perfect use. In condoms, female 21% in typical use and 5% in perfect use. 15% after use and 2% in perfect use. Combined oral contraceptive 8% in typical use, 0.3% in perfect use, and POP and the patch is 8% in typical use, ring after using ring 8% in typical use, 3 month injectable 3% after typical use, and intrauterine device is copper 0.8% after typical use, and the 3 years implant 0.05% after typical use, female sterilization 0.5% typical use, and after the at the end of the year or after 1 year, there is a 100% result. And male sterilization 0.15% or after typical use and perfect use 0.10% and 100% at the end of the year. Coming to recent advances. First article is the socio-demographic determinants of unmet need for the family planning among the married women in Pakistan. Family planning is considered as an effective tool to control the population or bring the improvement in the maternal and child health. Secondary data on the Pakistan demographic and health survey 2012 and 13 has to analyze the determinants of unmet need of the family planning. And the conclusion of the result is the fear of the side effects for using contraceptive has been identified as the major cause of unmet need for the family planning in Pakistan. The government of Pakistan has been putting a lot of efforts to convince people about the usefulness of the population control programs. A huge media campaign has been launched to pursue and the people about the benefits of the birth control, but the efforts of government do not seem to be very much effective to clear the perception of the people about side effect of contraceptive use. Hence, the fear of side effects still remain one of the most important reasons behind unmet need for the family planning. And the second article is raising the contraceptive prevalence rate to 50% by 2025 in Pakistan, an analysis of the number of users and the service delivery channels. Pakistan is the fifth populated country in the world with a population that is growing 0.4%. After a survey, the results our national target of 50% CPR by 2025 translate into the population of 20 million users. Currently, 11.26 million married women of reproductive age use any method. 8.22 million use modern method and 4.94 million this in the past 12 months. Of these, 2.7 million did so for social marketing outlets and 0.76 billion from the public sector. Outreach through media health workers, 0.55 million from the private sector, 0.88 million from the public sector facilities. However, aiming at the TPR target, that means expanding annual service delivery from 4.94 to 13.7 million users, since the social market it may have only public and private health facilities are likely to channel for such an expansion target. And the table of the same article that showing current CPR in 2017 in Punjab, there was 38% CPR, and in Sindh was 31%, and KPK 31%, and Balochistan 20%. Where the target in Punjab is 50%, 1% in KP it is 46%, in Balochistan it is 36%, in Islamabad it is 46%, it should be 62%, and national 34%, and the target is 50% by 2020. Now coming to the multiple choice questions. First MCQ is, Saima, a 30-year-old woman, is interested in the natural contraceptive method that involves monitoring her basal body temperature. That method relies on the fact that a woman's temperature rises slightly after ovulation. What is this called? A, fitness-based methods, withdrawal methods, lactation amenorrhea methods, standard day method, or diaphragm method? Answer is A, fertility method. MCQ number 2 is, a couple in their early 40s have completed their family, are looking for the long-term contraceptive solution. They want a non-hormonal option. Which type of IUD is a non-hormonal long-acting contraceptive method? Option A is IUD, B is hormonal IUD, C is emergency IUD, D is barrier IUD, D is diaphragm IUD. Answer is option A. Option number 3 is, Sara is a 32-year-old woman who has 2 children, wishes to prevent any further pregnancies. She is considering contraceptive option. Which of the following method is the long-acting reversible contraceptive that Sara should discuss with her healthcare provider? Option A is condom. Option 2 is birth control pill. Option C is Depo-Provera injection. Option D is IUD. Option E is emergency contraceptive. Answer is D, trying devices. Number 4 is, a married couple are planning to have their first child. They want to optimize their chances of conception. Which factor is crucial for the fertility and conception? Option A, hormonal contraceptive. B, avoiding sexual intercourse during the menstrual cycle. C is maintaining a healthy body weight. D is smoking and sexual consumption. E is irregular sleep pattern. Answer is option C, maintaining a healthy body weight. MCQ number 5 is, Lisa is a 20-year-old married girl. She wants a contraceptive method she can use only when needed. Which of the following method is stable on-demand contraceptive option? Birth control pill, emergency contraception, or intrauterine devices? Answer is option D, emergency contraception. Old female is using a hormonal contraceptive method and experience mood swings as a side effect. She wants to switch a non-hormonal option. Which of the following method is a non-hormonal contraceptive that she might consider to avoid mood-related side effects? Option A, birth control pill. Option B, contraceptive injection, contraceptive implants, copper intrauterine devices, or option E is hormonal intrauterine system. It is D, copper intrauterine devices. MCQ number 7 is, Naeem is 30-year-old man who is exploring contraceptive option with his partner. They are considering the use of condoms. What is the potential advantages of using condoms in terms of side effects? A, option is hormonal fluctuation. Option B, skin irritation. Option C, reducing risk of sexually transmitted infections. Option D, menstrual irregularities. Option E is headache. Answer is C. And 8 MCQs is, a woman 35 years of age, smokers, para 2, abortion 1, wants to use contraceptive pills for birth spacing. The gynecologist advised her not to use the contraceptive pills because these are most associated with the risk of option A, cervical cancer, B is bronchitis, C is breast cancer, D is coronary heart disease, E is peripheral neuropathy. आंसर इज डी, कोरोनरी हार्ट डिजीज। नाइन एमसीक्यूज इज 30-year-old फीमेल पैरा वन सफरिंग फ्रॉम द पीआईडी कम टू द फैमिली प्लानिंग क्लिनिक वांट टू सीक एन एडवाइस फ्रॉम द डॉक्टर रिगार्डिंग कॉन्ट्रासेप्शन। विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग कॉन्ट्रासेप्टिव मेथड इज कॉन्ट्राइंडिकेटेड इन द फीमेल पेशेंट। ऑप्शन ए इंजेक्टेबल हार्मोन, ऑप्शन बी ओरल कॉन्ट्रासेप्टिव पिल, ऑप्शन सी कंडम, डी इज नॉर प्लांट्स, ई इज इंट्रायूट्राइन डिवाइस। आंसर इज ई, इंट्रायूट्राइन डिवाइस। एमसीक्यू नंबर 10 इज अ 35-year-old वुमेन इज कंसर्न अबाउट द हार्मोनल कॉन्ट्रासेप्टिव मेथड एंड इज कंसीडरिंग अ परमानेंट ऑप्शन। शी वांट अ मेथड दैट डज नॉट इन्वॉल्व हार्मोन्स। विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज नॉन हार्मोनल परमानेंट कॉन्ट्रासेप्टिव मेथड। विजेक्टमी, ट्यूबलाइजेशन, कॉन्ट्रासेप्टिव इम्प्लांट्स, इंट्रायूट्राइन डिवाइसेस और स्टरलाइजेशन बाय केमिकल। नाइन्थ में आंसर इज स्टरलाइजेशन बाय केमिकल, सॉरी। टेंथ आंसर इज, सॉरी आंसर इज बी, ट्यूबल लाइट डिशन। देयर इज द की ऑफ माय देयर इज द यूट्यूब लिंक ऑफ आवर चैनल। काइंडली लाइक एंड सब्सक्राइब एंड थैंक यू।